To watch more videos and support our channel, Dalit Poetry and Literature, please subscribe.
Sitabai Gaikwad, deceased. Gitabai, Sitabai and Ramabai were three sisters, daughters of Rakhmaji Bapurao Dani. The father had a little land as a Hadki Hadwali endowment, land which is traditionally used to slaughter sick animals or to clean the carcasses of dead cattle. Such land is sometimes allotted to Mahar. The family, including his wife, three daughters and two sons, earned a meager subsistence from this land. Sitabai was the eldest daughter. She was married to Bhaurao Krishnarao Gaikwad in 1921, when she was just 12 years old. At the time of the marriage, Bhaurao paid Sitabai's father 1¼ anna as a bride price. It was a good match, for although Sitabai had no education, her husband was a non-matriculate, which in those days meant that he had gone to school up to the 11th standard. Also, it was a good family with a large landholding. It was a big household with several brothers and their wives and children. Sitabai's husband, Bhaurao Gaikwad, was a trusted activist working with Baba Sahib. So there were always a coming and going of guests, and it fell to Sitabai to look after their needs and serve meals to them. She would get up at dawn and grind flour, then make the bhakris and vegetables, giving special care to each task. Besides this, she also worked in the movement with Bhaurao, who was known in public as Dada Sahib. 14 years after their marriage, the couple still had no child. The household lacked for nothing, but Sitabai was distressed that she had not borne a child. Finally, in 1928, she got her own young sister, Geeta, married to Dada Sahib, and cheerfully accepted her into the household. The middle sister, Ramabai, had meanwhile been married to Dada Sahib's brother, Appa Sahib. And so all three sisters began to live together happily in the same family. All three sisters were interested in social activism. This was the time when women, dutifully standing by the men, took a part in the Kalaram temple entry of 1930. Sitabai was in the forefront of this movement. Dada Sahib's friend and co-workers and Shivraj and Rajbhoj and even Baba Sahib himself had great respect for her. Sitabai was a wonderful cook. In those days, Yashwantrao Chavan, Congress Party leader from Maharashtra, often visited Dada Sahib Gaikwad's home. Even though the two had different spheres of activity, they were good friends. Yashwantrao specially enjoyed eating brinjals with black masala and bhakri made by Sitabai. He used to call her Annapurna, the one who feeds people to satisfaction. In 1946, Sitabai went to Pune to participate in Satyagraha along with Dada Sahib. She also took active part in the Satyagrahas of the landless that he organized. At the time of partition of India in 1947, arrangements had been made to provide refugees and displaced persons with rations, clothes and food grains at Kurukshetra in North India. When Baba Sahib pointed out to Nehru that untouchability was being practiced there, he appointed Dada Sahib to look after the arrangements. Sitabai also followed, accompanied by Rajbhoj, and for some days she worked with the people of the Bhangi community. Together with the refugees, she too had to suffer caste prejudice. As a result, Dada Sahib resigned from the assignment on 23rd April 1948. Sitabai was sorry to leave the camp for the joy of serving the people, and caring for them had made her forget the pains of untouchability.